Jerry.
Yeah.
School board.
The school board, yeah, SAU 90. I'm sure you all realized that the center school had won the blue ribbon recognition for being one of the best schools in New Hampshire and the country in terms of what they do, you know, which is pre-K through grade two. And I think they're deserving. That's a solid school over there. I've been over there a few times reading to the kids and so on, and they really pay attention to the fundamentals over there. They are grinding at the reading and the writing and getting those kids with sound foundations when they go into grade three. Very good setup, very good system in there. So they joined Marston School that received last year the blue ribbon. So we got two schools out of three at this point that have been recognized statewide and countrywide. We're giving out Chrome notebooks now. We've got a plan that gives out about 300 a year. We're starting with grade three and grade six this year. Then those kids move on next year. We'll carry them into grade four, into grade seven, and we'll give out 300 more to the grade three and grade six. So about the 3 years, all sixth grades will have their computers, notebooks, Chromes, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're putting technology into their hands. They're taking them home to be used. They can be used wireless. If not wireless, I believe the superintendent's working on a way to get them into a hardwired connection somehow. If they have a phone line or whatever, or Comcast. This way here, we have teachers that can give lessons on bad days, perhaps. They can communicate the lesson plans, or kids can work at home. Kids can work at school. They're going to learn how to use these. Teachers are going to learn how to use them. They're learning how to use them now, training to them accordingly. And we're putting it into their hands. My granddaughter in Atlanta, she didn't have one. I went to Best Buy and bought her one. And I had them simply pick it up in Smyrna, Georgia, because I feel they got to have technology in their hands. Mm-hmm. They've got to be computer literate, especially when they graduate from high school. They better understand, because all jobs require it today, relatively speaking. So we're starting in third grade this year and sixth grade. Next year, those kids will move on. The new third graders and the sixth graders will get, and the following year be the last 300. And then after that, they're ours. And what we do with them after that, we can continue to use them, we can sell them, but they're ours to do, whatever.
We've bought those, though, right?
Yeah.
Jerry?
Okay. Well, they're lease.
They're right leased.
But at the end of the three-year situation,
right,
they're ours.
They're ours.
At the end of the lease.
At the end of 3 years.
End of 3 years, more technology comes along and makes them obsolete.
Well, we'll see. You know, you never know how, I mean, you know, most of us are sitting with computers more than 3 years old. And then budgeting starts for us in November. We have two dates established already. I'm champing at the bit. And, I'm waiting to see what the book looks like. I know the superintendent's been working on it with Nate. And they know where I come from on most of the subjects anyway.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm anxious to see what gets presented and begin that process. That's kind of where we are now.
Thank you. Bob?
I just have a question for the...
Oh, sure, I'm sorry.
I was told they couldn't bring them home yet.
Oh, no, we want them to go home with them.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, that's what the superintendent told me, because I asked the question, right away they won't be allowed to take them home.
No, I mean, that's not the plan. The thing is, they're trying to find a case for them. Right. You know, so if they drop them, they don't...
Right, well, that was my whole...
So they're looking around, Nate's looking around for cost-effective protective cases.
There were two messages here, right? I mean, the younger kids are not going to be taking them home right away, but the older kids will be. I think that's what
was...
I didn't know
that.
Yeah.
That's not what I heard.
Yes, that's what was said at the last time.
Because then they put it in, over time.
Yeah, and they're going to have...
But they weren't going to be able to immediately...
Well, maybe that is the case, but as I understand it, the plan is that they're going to be able to take them home eventually.
Eventually.
Maybe phase it in per year, but they're engraving them now with an ID number, and they're getting the cases for them and so on, but I believe they're already here. So I think this is a real great step forward.
Oh, it's a great thing, but that was the whole reason why I brought it up with the last meeting was because, they take them home, okay, they break, who pays for it?
Yeah. They realized there would be some loss.
There is, exactly
the presentation.
Right.
There's a scrap factor figured in.
Yeah, they factored in that there would be some loss, there would be some breakage, and they had numbers to go by. Mm-hmm. matter of fact, they covered that pretty good.
Yes.
We run the last meeting and we went into that in detail because I think we...
Hey, a few broken computers, damaged right. computers, I don't mind. We're putting technology in their hands. Right. If they stumble and fall and get up, it's very important to get them literate.
But that's where I was going with it as far as taking them home. I was like, I was hoping they would be able to take them home.
They are.
Especially for those that can't afford them.
Yes, they are going to be able to take them home and eventually. Maybe there is a phase and plan to your point, but I didn't hear it.
Okay.
Sometimes I have selective hearing.
Michael.
I want to thank you guys. It puts me out of business for the PCs for kids. The only one I have to worry about now is the last 15 I gave to Seabrook. So maybe you can move Seabrook in the same direction.
I think this is great.
I think it's a good idea.
What an opportunity is this? When I was in third grade, do you remember when you were in third grade? I mean, they had inkwells. The guy came in and put ink in it. You know what I mean? Now we got, you know.
I don't remember the inkwells. That must have been before my time.
Hey, Mike, and we had a feather.
Mr. Pluffo, what was that like?
Yeah. All right. Then.